General Soleimani is somebody who is under a United Nations travel ban. And when he travels to Iraq, it is in violation of a UN Security Council resolution. The travel ban that is currently in place is going to expire in 12 months because of the Iran nuclear deal. And so we think it's important for the UN Security Council to renew the travel ban on Qasem Soleimani and to ensure that he is not able to travel outside of Iran. He has made trips to Iraq. Anytime he's in Iraq, it is a bad day for the Iraqi people. And they have done everything they can to do in Iraq what they did 40 years ago in Lebanon, is to build up these militias that undermine the sovereignty and the prosperity and the security of the Iraqi people. And I would just say to the Iraqi people, the Iraqi Kurdistan, whenever you see President Rouhani come into Iraq, understand that what he did to his own people, trapping them in a cycle of poverty, is exactly what they would like to do in Iraq if they're allowed to dominate the region as they aspire to. We're pretty confident in our foreign policy. What we're seeing now in Iran, they're in a state of panicked aggression. And they've never been put in this place before. Many regime officials have said that this is unprecedented pressure that they're under. They deserve to be under this pressure. And if we're going to get the kind of deal that covers all of Iran's threats to peace and security, it's going to require a lot of leverage. And we have put in place enormous leverage, which we intend to use in talks with the Iranian regime when they're ready to talk. But the Iranian economy is already in a deep recession, and it's going to get worse. It's going to eventually go to a depression if this regime doesn't prioritize the welfare of its own people over exporting a violent and revolutionary ideology.